Welcome. This is your district-wide update. It's packed with stories that share the Dubuque Community School District experience. Let's get started. How do you honor a humble award-winning math teacher who's being honored by the President of the United States? Well, you simply don't tell her. Sageville Elementary School held a surprise assembly for their math teacher, Ann Johnson, to celebrate her latest achievement, receiving the Presidential Award for Excellence in Mathematics and Science Teaching. Let's be honest, this is a big deal. She is one among 213 teachers in all 50 states, the District of Columbia, Puerto Rico, and the U.S. territories to be honored with this award. But why Ann? Well, as she strives to help every student reach excellence in critical thinking and problem solving, she also strives to enhance how we teach.
The one thing about Ann is that she continues to be a learner herself. She challenges all of us to be learners and to do the best that we can for our students. So it's great to share enthusiasm with a colleague like that, and she's kind of contagious that way.
As a presidential honoree, Ann will receive a $10,000 award to be used at her discretion and an invitation to travel to Washington, D.C. for educational and celebratory events. Well done and congratulations, Ann Johnson, on this tremendous award. Growing minds through planting seeds. It's metaphorical and literal for us here at the Dubuque Community School District. School gardens have taken form at several of our schools, including our Alta Vista campus, representing the district in this year's Driftless Farm Crawl, presented by Four Oaks and Dubuque County ISU Extension and Outreach.
It's important for our kids to see that there's people out there that appreciate what we're doing, and they have a passion for gardening and harvesting food, and that's a very contagious thing.
Our farm-to-school stop offered the community of all ages the opportunity to partake in discussions, activities, and demonstrations, led by our students, staff, and other partnering organizations.
We're just here to show people that what we're doing here and how students are able to interact with this stuff. Some people think it's just a garden, but it's a lot more than just a simple garden. It's a place that people can come, relax a little bit, and partake in some of the harvest or interact with the chickens.
As encouraged by our food and nutrition department, the benefits of locally sourced food items is key, and what our gardens are about, the cycle of sustainability and care.
One of our goals was to make it a community garden. We have students bring their families into the garden and they can take some of the food home and enjoy it. I think we are impacting our local food landscape. It's important that people see the whole process from farm to table.
Who knew that our energy and effort could be so nourishing? Well, great for the community. This was a day that showed off the spirit and pride our students take in cultivating their gardens. And uniquely for the ALC, raising chickens.
What are you doing back then?
Very proud of my school for this because our garden looks amazing. It was a big turnout today. Everybody that showed up loved the chickens, loved the garden.
I'm very proud. If they ever call me back or anything, I would come back. So that's how proud I am of this.
Thanks to all those who crawled their way to the Alta Vista campus. Okay, that one was for the worms. Fifth graders, leaders of our elementary schools, but beginners in our music departments. Being in fifth grade opens the opportunity for our students to join band or orchestra. So to get the music started, all 13 elementary schools hosted an instrument tryout day.
The flute, I didn't get it at first, but then when I kept practicing, I had got it. And I didn't want to be in band, but when I tried it, it was exciting.
Here's the really cool thing about our district. Every single fifth grade student gets to experience the tryouts. That means every student gets the chance to produce these crazy noises.
So not every district does it this way, but it was philosophically decided a number of years ago that it was important to let every kid have that opportunity. For some of these kids, this is the only chance that they're going to have.
Now our general music program does introduce instruments of all types to our students well before the fifth grade. But this is the first time for many of them to try the instruments out.
It was fun because I got to try instruments that I never tried before, like a clarinet. It was tickling my throat and it was funny.
Whether it's a trombone, clarinet, or cello, playing any instrument can be financially challenging. But in our district, we make sure all students get a chance to play. Donations secured by the Foundation for Dubuque Public Schools, along with those of the Chanley and Fall families, help us make that possible.
Within the school district now, we have acquired a lot of instruments through grants, through donations, and I think that Dubuque is kind of ahead of the curve with a lot of that. The ultimate goal is to put an instrument in a kid's hands that is going to be theirs, take ownership in it so that they continue to play it.
Happy playing to all our fifth grade students. This bonus story is all about thanking you. The Dubuque Community School District Physical Plant and Equipment Levy was passed for an additional 10 years in a recent special election. That means for 10 more years, our district will have access to funding that supports safety enhancements, new buses, technology infrastructure, roof repairs, remodels, and much, much more. The levy passed with more than an 80% voter approval. All we can say is thank you. Thank you to all who supported this levy that will continue to enrich the quality of education we provide to students every day. Well, that's what we have for you this time. Stay connected with us by checking out our website, www.dbqschools.org, or follow us on social media. Thanks for watching.